To the uninitiated, a construction job site can appear to be a bit overwhelming. Seemingly chaotic scene of movement by dozens or even hundreds of workers. In truth, it's a choreographed event that involves thousands of decisions that begin long before a shovel of dirt is even turned, and don't end until the job is complete. It's within this framework that the relationship between labor and management is critical to success. For generations, the NECA IBEW Powering America team has not only been the gold standard of electrical construction, it has had a system in place that keeps disagreements within the family. It's called the Council on Industrial Relations, or CIR, and it keeps jobs on track and customers happy. This year marks the 100th anniversary of CIR, and it's become a shining example of what's possible when two groups want to work together, but sometimes just disagree on how to get there.
What makes CIR so unique and what makes it work is not how we're going to agree, it's how we disagree. We're never going to agree 1,000%. The uniqueness of the gentlemen and ladies wearing IBEW hats, the uniqueness of the NECA contractors and members wearing the NECA hat. What is so unique is the ability to understand how we're going to disagree for the good of the industry. That's a hard task.
The Council on Industrial Relations, which convenes in Washington, D.C., is the final stop where contractors and labor are provided the opportunity to be heard, to settle differences, and move forward together. Unlike the arbitration process and other business arenas, the third party hearing the cases, the CIR panelists, come from the same industry.
And so that brings a whole new perspective when they can deliberate and talk about an issue that's hanging out there, and you know, we can try to reach a reasonable resolution, because it's all about the industry in the end.
At any given moment, the Powering America team is hard at work at hundreds of job sites, involving tens of thousands of people. As well-oiled as our machine is, it's only being honest to say that on rare occasions, issues that just don't seem to have any easy answer locally find their way to Washington, D.C. for deliberation and resolution. And it's because of this council that jobs continue uninterrupted while disagreements are solved without involving the owner. Decisions must be unanimous, and the rulings are put in writing. This long NECA IBEW tradition of stability has saved billions of dollars in lost man-hours or construction disruption because of the goodwill and steady hand of those asked to serve on the panel.
But at the end, when they're done, you know, it needs to make sure that it's a unanimous decision and everybody goes out and supports that decision in the end.
Before I became NECA CEO, I was a contractor. One of my greatest sales tools as a contractor to a company or to an end user was, hey, I don't know what you believe about unionized labor. I don't know what you believe about unionized companies. But let me say this much. I have no strike. I have no lockout. I have no shutdowns. We have a process in place. We'll never involve your facility.
We settle through this procedure.
For Electric TV, I'm Dominic Gerritano. Be sure to follow us on social media for behind-the-scenes extras and industry information.